God that the Nigeria Defense Academy lost 3 great souls yesterday? Because news reaching us already is that Danton Christopher, who was adopted in the early hours of Tuesday, August 24th, by armed bandits at the Nigeria Defense Academy, Kaduna, has been found dead. According to reports, his body was found Tuesday evening, hours after news went viral that the bandits are demanding for 200 million naira ransom to set him free. The major was kidnapped during a raid at the Nigeria Defense Academy, Kaduna, which left 2 others dead. The deceased major is said to be expecting a child with his wife. From all stories, the NDA is said to be opposite a polytechnic in Kaduna State that was attacked just some few days or weeks ago. After such attack, is that environment not supposed to be under close watch by security forces? And one stupid northern governor fit open mouth say they were not bandits but armed robbers. Wallahi, this our so-called federal government not know say the rain and sun we have fall for poor man head, nice till they fall for rich man. If you dey understand parable, you go understand waiting I just talk. The rain will fall for A roof, nice till they fall for B roof. Please give this video a like, and please, if this is your first time on this channel, subscribe to my channel. Thank you. The news: Buhari is Nigeria's number one enemy, per Adebanjo. The leader of Afanifere Sociocultural Organization, per Ayo Adebanjo, has identified President Muhammadu Buhari as the number one enemy of Nigerians, disclosing that the trusts that used to be among the diverse ethnic nationalities of Nigeria has been eroded under his administration. Please don't forget to give us a thumbs up, and please hit on the subscription button down below. I see you as you do so. May the blessings of God never cease to overflow in your lives as you all support my channel. Amen. Niger News reports that the non-Agenarian stated this on Wednesday during the Ripple's Nigeria Dialogue titled "Rebuilding Trust in a Divided Nigerian." Advancing the conversation, the talk shop also had in attendance the governor of Delta State, Ifeanyi Okonwa, Honorable Osei Onyeagbosa, Northern Elders Forum spokesman Dr. Akeem Baba Ahmed, and Professor Usman Yusuf. The man ruling us now made the trust deficit among the several ethnic groups in Nigeria made it worse. What is bad is bad. I had campaigned for Buhari in 2007 when he promised to ensure the restructuring of Nigeria. Even Tinubu foolishly had an agreement with Buhari ahead of the 2015 presidential election to ensure the restructuring of Nigeria if elected. Buhari has been ruling us with impunity. How can we trust such a man? Even members of his cabinet don't trust him. To rebuild trust in Nigeria, we have to pray to God to convince Buhari to support restructuring, he said, regretting that Buhari did not negotiate with us calling for restructuring, but is negotiating with bandits. He stated that the actions and inactions of Buhari are unwittingly maligning his ethnic group, and wondered why people from his ethnic group are not calling the president to order. The elder statesman, who said he has been in the struggle for a better Nigeria for over 70 years, pointed out that the ethnic menace is not a new phenomenon, but came to a climax under the current dispensation of President Buhari. If Buhari does not know what restructuring is about, he should go and read the independent constitution adopted by the Sudaner Obafemi Awolowo and Nnamdi Azikiwe. The 1960 constitution made Nigeria so peaceful. The regions had autonomy and even had embassies abroad. Please give this video a like, and please, if this is your first time, please hit on the subscription button. Thanks and God bless. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.